मैडम प्लीज अनम्यूट एंड स्टार्ट मैडम।
A very good morning to all. I, Kavya Shriyas, Assistant Professor, Department of Information Science and Engineering, take immense pleasure to welcome you all for the 5-day faculty development program on research and innovation. I also thank our supportive management for giving us this opportunity. I also welcome and thank our principal, Dr. D. Sadashive Gowda, for his constant support. I also welcome our beloved Head of Department, Dr. Rajendra sir. I request Dr. Rajendra sir to speak a few words.
Okay, good morning, one and all. Myself, Dr. A.B. Rajendra, Professor and Head, Information Science Engineering, Vidyavartha College Engineering, Mysuru, and also convener of this program. Firstly, I would like to express my sincere thanks to our management and our principal, Dr. B. Sadashiv Gowda, for supporting to conduct this 5-day webinar series on research and innovation from Department of Information Science Engineering in association with Institution Innovation Council and Innovation Club is organizing 5-day series. First day, webinar on intellectual property rights by Dr. G.B. Krishnappa, Professor and Dean, R&D. He will be giving lecture on how to set up, how to file a patent, and is having a large experience under IPR cell, around 12 patents filed under G.B. Krishnappa sir. And second day, Professor Mohan Krishna, he will highlight about how to do online courses and how to do papers, other things. Day three, by Dr. Rajkumar, is a research manager, CL Educate Limited, New Delhi. He'll be telling the tips how to write the paper, how to send papers to Web of Science, Scopus Index, and drafting the paper, everything he'll explain in day three. In day four, our own student and also UAF fellow, Apurva Singh, she'll highlight about design thinking. And last day, Dr. Vinay KB, he'll be explaining about entrepreneurship development through TBA. He's an associate professor of Department of Mechanical Engineering, VVC Mysore. So I welcome you all. Now I request Balu Vijay sir, the coordinator. And also I thank the event coordinators, Dr. Kasim Ali, Balu Vijay, Prakash Kian, Gagana, and Kavishri for coordinating this event. Now I request Balu Vijay sir to introduce our today's speaker and also Dean, Research and Development, Vidyavartha College of Engineering, Mysuru. Over to Balu Vijay sir.
Thank you, sir. It's my pleasure and honor to introduce my guiding force, Dr. G.P. Krishnappa sir, to the audience. Professor Dr. G.P. Krishnappa sir is the Dean of Research and Development at Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, Mysuru. He has set up a R&D center along with Mr. Vinod B., Assistant Professor at Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, Mysuru, worth of rupees 70 lakh with a financial assistance of rupees 33 lakh from Karnataka Council for Technological Upgradation, KCTU. Currently, he is working on a 35 lakh DRNS-sponsored project. Sir has published over 40 papers in conferences and journals. He has 25 years of teaching and research experience. He has filed 3 patents, among which 2 have already been published. His 2 projects have been selected among the top 10 projects in All India Level Competition, India Innovation Initiative, in 2009 and 2010, organized by DST, Government of India, CII, and Agilent Technologies. His areas of interest are design, energy, thermal science, and cryogenics. He has guided a research scholar for PhD and presently is guiding 5 research scholars. He is a fellow of Institution of Engineers India, life member of ISTE, Indian Cryogenic Council, ISHRAE, and a member of IEEE. I now request the Professor Dr. G.P. Krishnappa sir to take over the session. Thank you, sir.
I thank the management of Vidyavardhaka Sangha, Principal Dr. B. Sadashivaya Gowda of Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, Convener Dr. A.B. Rajendra, Professor and Head Department of Information Science and Engineering, and the coordinators of this event, Professor D. Kasimwali, Professor Balu Vijay S.N., Professor Prakasha K.N., Professor Gagana S. and Professor Kavya Shri S. Respected viewers, namaste to each one of you. So today I'd like to share with you whatever the knowledge I have on intellectual property rights. So basically we are all engineers, but all the human beings are born with the creativity. So whenever I use it to say on what is engineering, I use it to give definition like engineering is the application of maths, science and governing principles in order to obtain solutions for the problems faced by the society in general and problems in specific by the industries. But now I have to change the definition of engineering. Our management, Vidyavardhaka Sangha, had invited Professor K. Bhairappa, the Pro-Chancellor of Adichunchinagiri University, as the chief guest for the 74th Independence Day celebration. And he used to tell that we have to include arts in engineering and medical students have to study engineering, especially mechanical engineering. And engineering in the due course have to include medicines in their syllabi. That means, you know, that the distinction between science, engineering and technology has vanished decades ago. So now we need to include everything in our education. Otherwise, it becomes incomplete. So now if you say that, define engineering means, engineering is the application of arts, science, commerce, maths, and common sense in order to obtain solutions for the problems of the society. I have to say like this. Dear respected viewers, so now in the present day context, engineering means innovation. So without innovation, engineering, the meaning of engineering is very minimal, or to say it is zero. Engineers are problem solvers. So we know that our ancestors are greatest engineers. They didn't have formal degree like what we have, but they use it to solve the problems very effectively. So now even a common man without much knowledge on scientific principles and all, able to give better solution, better than an engineer in some cases. Human beings, as I already mentioned, born creative. If that creative idea is converted into physical reality, it is called invention. If that invention has some commercial value, and if it is useful for many, it is called innovation. Hence, now onwards, we have to call engineering means innovation. So through innovation, one can serve the society to a greater extent and also can make lot of money. So before going to discuss on intellectual property rights, I'd like to narrate a story that is real story. In the year 2016, we had invited Dr. Martin J. Branch. So he is actually director in BMS College of Engineering for research and development. So when he was in the chamber in BMS College of Engineering, a person entered into chamber and he wished Professor Martin J. Branch and he asked, "Sir, do you recognize me?" So Professor Dr. Martin J. Branch recollects his memory and said, "Yes, I do remember, but I don't know your name. I'm sorry for that. Sir, I am your student at Dr. Ambedkar Institute of Technology, Bengaluru. Dr. Martin J. Branch was the principal then. And this fellow, when he was studying his fourth semester electrical and electronics engineering at Dr. AIT, went to Dr. Martin J. Branch's chamber and showed him an idea, creative idea. "Sir, I have this idea. Can you please go through this and tell me whether it is patentable?" And Martin J. Branch went through it and he was happy on this idea and he said, "Yes, when it is get converted into physical reality, so it can be patentable." "So now, sir, I have a request. Can you please come onto the road?" Like that is asked the principal. So then Martin J. Branch so followed him onto the road and this fellow showed, "See, sir, this is a new Benz car worth 75 lakh rupees worth. And I am directly coming from the showroom. I have a wish that you have to seated beside me." And he obliged. And this fellow took Dr. Martin J. Branch to Kormangala, where actually he is residing, the former student of Dr. AIT residing. And it's a huge bungalow. And in that, a swimming pool is also there. And he showed that swimming pool, "Sir, this is for my kid." And this Martin J. Branch got astonished. "How it is possible for you to own this huge bungalow? Then actually, you know that at 20 by 30, a corner in Kormangala costs about 1.1 crore. And this is a huge bungalow with swimming pool and all amenities." So usually it is surprised to Dr. Martin J. Branch. And he is asked how it is possible. And he said, "Sir, I told you, no, sir, that a patent actually granted. And after the patent granted, Siemens and General Electricals called me for negotiation to USA. And actually I sold this one to Siemens. With that license amount, he was able to procure all these assets. That is the power of innovation. So let's go to discuss about intellectual properties. Contents of my presentation: what is IP and IPR? Why IPR? What involve IPR? Some case studies of infringements. What is IP and IPR? IP stands for intellectual property. Is a category of property that includes intangible creations of the human intellect. Hence, it needs some different way for its protection. You know that we can give some value for a table or a chair, mobile phone, pen, pencil, computer, etc. But we cannot give a definite value for human intellect. That's why it is called intangible. So human has intangible creations. What is intellectual property rights? Intellectual property rights are simply called IPR, are the exclusive legal rights over creations of the mind. IPRs are developed to protect the creative people who have disclosed their invention for the benefit of mankind. So mind has huge amount of power. Why intellectual property rights are required? Intellectual property rights protects inventor's creation from being copied or imitated without their consent or concern. So if someone steals your idea, so then actually you can sue that person. Without your consent and concern, if someone takes your idea, it is unethical. Intellectual property rights reward creativity and human endeavor, which fuel the progress of humankind. IPRs are essential to fostering innovation, to encourage inventiveness in various areas of research and development. Understanding the country's IP rights and following the best practices can drastically reduce the risk of losing the company's intellectual property. Then who protects intellectual property rights in India? Indian government has initiated various steps towards intellectual property rights protection. In India, intellectual property rights are safely protected and controlled by well-established statutory and judicial framework, that is Intellectual Property India. Office of the Controller General of Patents, Designs and Trademarks, Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India protects IPRs in India. Then in the world, WIPO, that is World Intellectual Property Organization, which was established by the WIPO Convention in 1967. The WIPO is a specialized agency of the United Nations. It promotes the production of IP throughout the world. Its headquarters are in Geneva, that is Switzerland. World Intellectual Property Day is observed every year on April 26 from 2000. We are at Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, also celebrate Intellectual Property Right Day. So in the year 2018, along with the Institution of Engineers, we had celebrated Intellectual Property Right Day. What involve IPR? Intellectual property rights as a collective term includes the following independent IP rights: patents, copyrights, trademarks, registered or industrial designs, trade secrets, and the geographical indications. Each one of them are different. Intellectual property mainly comprises of two distinct forms: literary and artistic works, and industrial property. Literary and artistic works involve books, paintings, musical compositions, plays, movies, radio or TV programs, performances like dance, etc., and other artistic works. How are they protected? They are protected by copyright. We might have seen on textbooks, we see this symbol, that is copyrights, that is books are copyrighted. Next, we have industrial property. Industrial property describes physical substance, that is the product of an idea or concept for commercial purposes. How are they protected? By patents, by trademarks, by industrial designs, and by trade secrets, and by geographical indications. Trade secrets is very new. It has started from 2000, 16. Patents, an exclusive right granted by a country to the owner of an invention to make, use, manufacture, and market the invention. The patent right is territorial in nature. Patents provide incentives to individuals by recognizing their creativity, and these incentives encourage further innovation. You can see a certificate of patent, granted certificate. Patents in India. India is a member state of World Intellectual Property Organization, Paris Convention, Patent Cooperation Treaty, and Budapest Treaty. Patent offices are located at Kolkata, Mumbai, Chennai, and Delhi to deal with the applications for patents. South India. In South India, actually, we have office at Chennai, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and Kerala belong to Chennai. Patent Information System and Intellectual Property Training Institute are located at Nagpur. What are trademarks? A trademark is a distinctive sign that provides to the owner of the mark by ensuring the exclusive right to use it to identify goods or services. Term of registered trademark, 10 years and renewable. To register a trademark, one should approach appropriate national or regional trademark office. WIPO administers an international registration system for trademarks. Some of the trademarks you see here: Indian Railways, Air India, Google, MGM, Melting Foods India, Indigo, Cadbury, Nestle, Samsung, Nandini, and Nama Metro, Bangalore Metro logo or trademark. Can you guess these common trademarks? I hope you'll recognize almost all of them. Here we have the answer. Yes, this is Android, this is Apple, McDonald's, Microsoft, Coca-Cola, perhaps some of you might not have recognized this, Shell, MSNBC, Microsoft, National Broadcasting Company, Corporation, Olympic, Target, Benz, Mercedes-Benz, Pepsi, Pillsbury, Mickey Mouse, Superman, and Nike. Next, we have industrial designs or registered designs. The ornamental or aesthetic aspects of an article, which may consist of 3D or 2D features, such as shape or surface, patterns, lines, or color. It makes an article attractive and appealing. Hence, they add to the commercial value of a product and increase its marketability. So here we can see the nano. So when it was actually invented, so they had applied for 30 designs for nano. Any technical features of the article are not protected by it. Industrial designs continued. Applicants can file a single international application either with WIPO or the national or regional office of a country. The design should be new or original, not previously published or used in any country before registration. Total term of a registered design is 10 years and 5 years extended period. These are all designs, so jewelry, phone, watch, etc. Next, we have geographical indications, GI, a sign used on goods that have a specific geographical origin and possess qualities or a reputation due to that place of origin. Registration of a GI, 10 years and renewable. The geographical indication of goods, Registration and Protection Act came into being in 2000. imprisonment for a term between 6 months to 3 years and a fine between 50,000 rupees to 2 lakh rupees in act for the culprits. Geographical indication of goods is under Act 19. Some geographical indications. In Karnataka, we have Chanapatna ties and also Mysore sandal soap, Mysore jasmine, Dharwada peda, etc. Only few have listed here for all these. Okay, Andhra Pradesh, Pochampalli Icat sari, Kondapalli bommalu, Tirupati laddu. Tripura, Queen pineapple. Tamil Nadu, Kanchipuram silk sari, Nilgiri tea, Coimbatore wet grinder, Tanjavur art plate. Kerala, Alepi green cardamom, Malabar pepper, Puthumpalli sari, Nendra banana or Nendra bale. Karnataka, Chanapatna ties and dolls. You can see here, ties and dolls. Mysore sandal soap, Mysore mallige, Mysore jasmine. Dharwad peda. Andhra Pradesh, Tirupati laddu, see here. Pochampalli Icat sarees. And Kondapalli bommalu. See, such type of dolls are used in advertisement also for sturdiness of the vehicle. Now, Tripura, Queen Pineapple, see, very huge and tasty, of course. And here you see Amitabh Bachchan, perhaps a brand ambassador. And here our Honorable President of India. Tamil Nadu, Kanchipuram silk sari, Nilgiri tea, Coimbatore wet grinder and Tanjavur art plate. So Coimbatore is famous for different type of machineries. This is actually, you know, that in a particular month, if in India there are 1 lakh wet grinders are produced, 75,000 wet grinders are produced in Coimbatore alone. That's why Government of India granted GI for this Coimbatore wet grinder. Kerala, Alepi green cardamom, Malabar pepper, Puthumpalli sari, and Nendra banana. Some case studies of infringements. In 2003, Bangalore, August 10, Banashankari police arrested 3 software engineers for illegally copying software from a company they were working for. Chennai, in the year 2000, pirated software worth rupees 1.11 crore was seized by the Chennai police. A total of 6 employees were arrested, which included the managing director of one outlet and proprietors of each of the outlets. Apple sued phone maker HTC and has filed a complaint with the US International Trade Commission alleging that the Taiwanese company is infringing 20 Apple patents related to the iPhone. Steve Jobs, then the Apple's CEO, said in a statement, "We think competition is healthy, but competitors should create their own original technology, not steal ours." It's applicable for all, okay, those who steal others. Some few typical cases. Amazon tried to patent its one-click payment option. However, the court decided it was too obvious an idea to patent. See, one-click payment, it's not that possesses that much innovativeness in it. Isaac Newton battled throughout his life with Gottfried Leibniz over the authorship of a book, though there were no copyright laws in effect at the time. I'd like to mention a point here that, so we are all affected by COVID-19. that is sometime. Actually, we had also experienced this lockdown and quarantine for some of the people. Newton discovered law of gravity during his quarantine period in the year 1665. Actually, in the year 1665 to 1666, Isaac Newton was home quarantined because of plague. It was very dangerous than COVID, what we are looking at. So what I mean to say that one, during this lockdown or quarantine period, most of the inventions or discoveries will take place, important discoveries or innovations or inventions. Some special cases, patent on turmeric. You know that Indians are very well known about the medicinal properties of turmeric. You know that most of the women in India so used to apply the paste of this turmeric on their faces, especially in Tamil Nadu. So they apply large amount of this turmeric powder. So because it gives a very bright looking face on that. So India has forced the US patent. Actually, this US got the patent on this medicinal properties of this turmeric. So then India has forced the US Patent and Trademark Office to revoke a contentious patent it granted few years ago to researchers in the United States on the use of powdered turmeric for wound healing. Indian scientists claim this is the first time that a move in the United States to patent a traditional remedy from the developing world has been successfully overturned. If India had not asked for revoking this patent, so USA would have patented it for a longer period of time. So whenever there is a traditional knowledge, so we have to protest against if somebody patented it. The similar case with patent on neem. The European Patent Office in Munich had granted a patent for the preparation of a fungicide derived from the seeds of the neem tree, but it was a well-known traditional practice of Indians. Hence, India had applied for revoking the patent. Finally, in the year 2000, the European Patent Office revoked the patent. Vandana Shiva, then the Director, Research Foundation for Science, Technology and Ecology, quoted, "It is a historic moment and will go a long way in giving confidence to the traditional users." Any traditional medicine actually should not be patented. In case if it's got patented, the user, traditional users must oppose it. So now we have some interesting facts. So look at these betel leaves or viledele. In Hindi, they call paan or paan ka patta, something they call. Paan ka patta, not patta. Patta means it is stone. So look, these betel leaves, viledele, are full of vitamins like vitamin C, thiamine, niacin, riboflavin, and carotene, and are a great source of calcium. That's why our ancestors used to chew this betel leaves along with the betel nut and with lime. It's very healthy. But we people, the modern, so-called modern people, are neglecting this. Let us look at top 10 benefits of betel leaf. Helps in treating diabetes, really surprising. Aids in weight loss, prevents carcinogens that lead to cancer, heals wounds, cures headache. And it also relieves pains from wounds or rashes, etc. That is analgesic in nature, eases constipation, improves digestion, reduces respiratory issues, and antiseptic and antifungal properties. So I have shown these two in a different colors, that is violet color. I'll come back to it. Again, so properties of jaggery, Bella, is in Hindi it is called gourd or gourd. It acts as a detox, as it helps cleanse the liver by flushing out nasty toxins from the body. Jaggery is loaded with antioxidants and minerals like zinc and selenium, which help prevent free radicals, which are responsible for early aging. It helps boost resistance against infections, hence building stronger immunity. Please look at this sentence also. It helps boost resistance against infections, hence building stronger immunity. Eating a piece of jaggery daily can help women combat PMS symptoms, including mood swings, menstrual cramps, and abdominal pain. So we had neglected the benefits of benefits of this Bella or jaggery. So we have been addicted to sugar because it is white, you know, that's why. And let me tell you one thing, after knowing these properties of this jaggery, boost resistance against infection and hence building stronger immunity, and also the properties of these betel leaves, reduces respiratory issues and antiseptic and antifungal properties. So I got some symptoms of this very cold, okay, common cold. I thought that it is affected by virus. I don't know exactly. Then what I did, I took 2 to 3 leaves of, if they are very small, 2 to 3 leaves. Actually, we have one plant in our house, 2 to 3 fresh leaves of this betel and a piece of jaggery. And I chewed for say 1 minute and all. We should not eat immediately, so we have to keep that one in our mouth. Okay, then we have to eat. It is surprising to say that actually that symptoms of cold got relieved within 10 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes maximum. Twice I did this one. Okay, got cured. Otherwise, you know that whenever I used to get this common cold, so it used to stay for a week, 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, like this. But after using this, actually it got cured immediately. So it may be useful for this fighting with the coronavirus. Maybe I am telling, because it has good properties. See, you know, usually you know that the person who is suffering from respiratory problems, so it cures respiratory problems. And see, it is antiseptic and antifungal properties. And this jaggery helps boost resistance against infections, hence building stronger immunity. Definitely, if you take these two combinations, a piece of jaggery with the 2 leaves of betel, and if you chew it, definitely will get stronger immunity. Those are suffering from diabetics may not use this, should not use this Bella or jaggery. They can take only betel leaves alone. And then properties of cinnamon, or chakke in Kannada we call dalchini in Hindi. It possesses powerful medicinal properties, and it is loaded with antioxidants. It is anti-inflammatory properties. It possesses anti-inflammatory properties. It may cut the risk of heart disease. It can improve sensitivity to the hormone insulin, and it lowers blood sugar levels and has a powerful anti-diabetic effect. See this. May have beneficial effects on neurodegenerative diseases, and it may protect against cancer. One more thing, cinnamon helps fight bacterial and fungal infections. You know that if you are suffering from cough, okay, take a piece of the cinnamon. Cinnamons are chakke. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಚಕ್ಕೆ ತೆಳ್ಳಗಿರೋ ಚಕ್ಕೆ ತಗೋಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಕಚ್ಚಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಿಹಿ ಬರಬೇಕು, ಸಿಹಿ ಅಥವಾ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಖಾರ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಒಗರು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಒಗರು ಬಂತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಚಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ದಪ್ಪಗಿರಬಾರ್ದು ಚಕ್ಕೆ, ಚಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮೋಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಮರದ ಚಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಚಕ್ಕೆ ತಗೊಂಡು ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಇಷ್ಟು ಚೂರು ತಗೋಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಾಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಚ್ಚಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹಾಗೆ ರಸ ಕುಡಿತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕೆಮ್ಮು ವಾಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಕಾಫ್ ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಡ್ರೈ ಕಾಫ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯೂರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿನಮಾನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೌತ್. ದಾಲ್ಚಿನಿ ಪೀಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಗುಡ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಸಿನಮಾನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಯೂಶಲಿ ಥಿನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಟು ದ ಥಿಕ್ಕರ್ ಒನ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಥಿನ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಚೀವ್ ಇಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಫಾರ್ ಲಾಂಗರ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೈಟ್, ಟೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸ್ಲೈಟ್ಲಿ ಬೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ರಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಜ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್. Definitely it cures and you will get good sleep as well because of this antibacterial and antifungal properties. These leaves are from the same tree, so most of the people use in making vegetable palaus. This it's also called palau leaves. Okay, different type of leaves. See, this structure is straight, other bones or something what we call here. Okay, for other leaves it is like this, ribs are what we call it. They are straight here. So if I know some properties of this traditional medicines, can I claim that I know this one, that one, like patent? We cannot. Traditional knowledge is our ancestors' knowledge, so we have to distribute or share our knowledge to the mass, to everyone. We should not apply for patent and all. That's why Popeye says that you cannot patent this Popeye. Popeye the sailor, it was very famous cartoon then. Now I don't know whether our children are watching this one. So look here. So whenever he is getting tired, I used to take this spinach. Or palak soap or spinach. It's very nutritious. So immediately you'll get the energy. See this. So we cannot even patent on this spinach or palak soap. An interesting case of infringement. So in the year 1985, Art Rogers took this photograph, a couple with the puppies like this, about 8 puppies. And in the year 1988, Jeff Koons created these dolls using polychrome, and you know, used it to sell, and he made lot of money by selling this. Is it not copy of this one? Definitely it's copy of this one. He cannot escape. Photographer Art Rogers shot a photograph of a couple holding a line of puppies in a row and sold it for use in greeting cards and similar products. Internationally renowned artist Jeff Koons, in the process of creating an exhibit on the banality of everyday items, ran across Rogers' photograph and used it to create a set of statues based on the image. Jeff Koons sold several of these structures, making a significant profit. Upon discovering the copy, Rogers sued Koons for copyright. Koons responded by claiming fair use by parody. You know that a photograph is actually artistic in nature, hence it is protected under copyright. So in Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, we have an IPSL through which actually we have filed patents, design and fabrication of mudde making machine, development of an automated tiller for agriculture purpose, solar water heater to supply hot water at constant temperature, and e-parking system, production of distilled water using low-cost evaporative cooling system, Dev Bore, secured electronic device charging station through biometric authentication. and patents filed by UIC faculty elsewhere. Congestion-free transportation for patents and VIPs through GPS tracking and early intimation. Sustainable energy harvesting using wireless sensor network through IEEE 802.11 based application to impart the efficiency. Method for medical image progressive transmission based on salient object detection. An optimal modified matrix encoding technique for secret rating in MPEG video using ECC. System and method of a hybrid control model for power quality improvement of wind energy conversion system with unified power quality controller. Recently published patents in different fields are just to give in which area actually inventions or innovations are taking place. It's not by our mechanical engineering, unidirectional rotating ocean wave energy conversion open turbine, published on 26/6/2020. Tubewell irrigation stop timer, that is also published in June, in the month of June 2020. Computer science or information science engineering, system and method for mobile agent security in a mobile ad hoc network. That is also same, published in the same date. An intelligent biometric system embedded in the Wi-Fi modem to secure access control. Electronics and communication engineering and electrical and electronics engineering. Grid-free decentralized solar cum windmill power plant with energy efficient electric loads for smart commercial buildings. Smart t-shirt. A smart t-shirt is a simple and easily wearable clothing which is provisioned for single sensor based monitoring cum alarm system towards continuously monitoring the correct sitting posture of the person wearing it and provide real-time alerts against any deviation from the correct sitting position or posture of the person who is wearing it. Very interesting case. So next to civil engineering, facet control structure. Next we have a system and method for preparing alternate dry fuel from hazardous waste for use in cement industry. See, everything must be made useful. Physics, magnetorheological fluid based flexible grinding setup, that is also in the month of June. Novel method for transforming waste printed circuit boards into a concentrated secondary resource of rare earth elements. It can be a joint venture, okay, interdisciplinary innovation. Chemistry, a contamination device for decontaminating objects. Aluminum powder as an innovative hot metal desulfurization reagent to replace magnesium. Disinfectant through steam of neem and turmeric herbs for public servants in COVID-19 pandemic. Very recently, so many inventions have been done during this COVID just to safeguard the public from this COVID pandemic. One such invention is disinfectant through steam of neem and turmeric herbs for public servants in a COVID-19 pandemic. I don't know whether it can be, okay, neem and turmeric herbs, but they are using in a different way. So now, fee for patent filing. There are three categories: natural person or persons, small entity, and others. So institutions like ours comes under others. A single person or two applicants can join together, and if it is a startup and if it is not earning a lot of money, so then application fees varies from 1,600 to 24,000 based on the number of claims and the number of drawings, etc. Small entity, 4,000 to 60,000. Others 8,000 to 1,20,000. If you want to have your invention published early, then you have to pay early publication fee. Natural person or startups 2,500. Small entity 6,250. Others 12,500. So, requesting for examination application is natural person 4,000 to 5,600. Small entity 10,000 to 14,000. And others 20,000 to 28,000. So, if you wish to file a patent through agency, so they may charge 1.2 lakh to 1.4 lakh. That's left to you only. Okay. And usually, a lawyer fee will also be there. So, in addition to these fee, so if we, in case some people go against your patent filing, so then you have to fight, then you have to spend money on that also. So last but one slide we have here. If you don't see a problem with this question, see here. So assume that this is an agency, or you can say this is officer in a patent office. These two are inventors. So they went to office. Then they asked this question. All I asked was, can I patent my copyrighted trademark? This fellow asked him, can I patent my copyrighted trademark? See this, what happens to him? That's why he is telling that if you don't see a problem with this question, then you need another class. If you don't understand this situation, then obviously you need another class. Thank you.
Thank you for the informative session, sir. We have a few questions. We have a few questions, sir.
Yes, madam, please.
The question is, can patents of any country be controlled by WIPO?
Of course. Actually, as you know, that patents are territorial in nature. Okay. So, if you file in an international level, and if you file that one through WIPO, obviously it will control.
The second question is there any royalty for GI registration?
Actually, I don't have much idea about this one. You may not get any royalty for that one because it is not an individual invention or property like that. It's actually geographical indication as it mentioned, it belongs to that area or territory. So, you may not get royalty for that. Then who will be the owner of that one? That will be a question mark. Next, madam.
We have third question. What is the duration of the patent? Is it for always or is there any period or validity for that?
It is mentioned in the slide. Actually, it is 20 years. Patent filing is 20 years and it can be renewed.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
For the insightful and
thank you
for the informative session, sir. Thank you so much. I also thank all the participants. Thank you, one and all.